going to cover today what DocuSign actually is and how to use it to approve and sign a single document and how to approve and sign multiple documents, and just show you briefly how it looks into going into Content Manager as well. So what is DocuSign? DocuSign is an electronic signature app. And in that, you can add your signatures and documents that can be uploaded, and then they're encrypted and a unique hash is created for them. So what that means is that if a document is later checked and that hash doesn't match, the information in there has obviously been tampered with or compromised. So it means that it's no longer secure and that changes might have been made after it was authorised. So it's a really good app to make sure that what has been approved is what is being presented at the end. DocuSign can also be used on different devices. So if you're mobile and you're on the train on the way home and you just want to use some time and sign some documents off, you can do that on your phone or on your iPad. So it's a great app to be able to use that way as well. Now, to use DocuSign as the authorisation process in Content Manager, you need to have a DocuSign subscription with Content Manager. It needs to be set up, and then all the users that you need that are going to authorise the documents need to have a DocuSign account. So that's what we'll be covering. So what I've done, like we've set up here how we do our timesheets. So we need to get our timesheets authorised each week, and we decide to use the DocuSign system as our authorisation process. So what I've done to make my view easier is I've actually added the document review state column so I can see at a glance what stage of document review my document is at. So if we get, and to do this, I should clarify when we start, because in Content Manager there is a document review process. I've skipped ahead there. In Content Manager there's a document review process. So you can use a record type, add the document review process to it, and documents can be reviewed and or authorised. And that's what we're using today. Within the authorisation process in Content Manager, you've got two options. You can either use, I'm just going to show you quickly. You can either use the simple service. So what happens is you can use Content Manager and flow your document through Content Manager and authorise it that way. Or you can use the DocuSign service, which is what we're going to use today and show you how to use. So if you're going to set up a record, you're going to have your document review tab, and this is where it shows if you can review your documents or if you can authorise them or do both. And if you want to authorise it, we just tick it here, use the add button to add the location that's going to be approving your document, and then make sure we've got the use DocuSign service selected and just click OK. So what that means, that's ready set up to go. It hasn't started the authorisation process yet, but when we're ready, it's got all the details in there to go. So I want this authorised now, it's ready to go. I'm going to go into document view and start authorisation. I'll then have to enter a date, and what will happen is the person that is authorising the record will get an email. If they are in your Content Manager or in your organisation, you're all using Content Manager, you'll get an email from Content Manager itself, a notification email to show you that a document can be authorised. And you'll also get an email from DocuSign, and that's the one that you need to use to access the actual record. So we're going to go through there, you click review document, and that will then open up the DocuSign app for you. So this, what this has done is take me directly into the DocuSign app. So it's got loaded up the document. This is a single document that I'm ready to sign. I'm just going to hit continue and it's ready to go. So prior to this stage all happening, Wyldlynx set up our DocuSign account, and I got an email to set up my own account, and I had to go in and add a signature. I could add my name, details, email address, company, and I could actually with the signature either choose a predefined signature or actually write my own in if I wanted to. So that's already in there and loaded, and I don't have to do that every time I go into a document. So it's all ready to go. So this one I'm reviewing, yes, this person's worked very hard, they've done very well, and I'm going to approve that. So it's simply a matter of clicking on signature and dragging it into place. So it's already there. If I want it to be bigger, because I think I'm really important, I'll make it huge, otherwise just make a small one there. So it's now signed that document. From here I can also add the date signed. If I want to add my initials, I can, and any other relevant information that will automatically put that in the document for you. So once you've added all the fields that you want to add, you just click finish, and that will then complete the document. I'm going to go back to my email once I've signed it. I'll then get an email showing that my document has been completed, so I can view the completed document here. Like at the end of the day, I've got like 10 documents that need to be authorised. Instead of going in through my Outlook and having to click review document on every single document, I can go straight into DocuSign app itself, and I'll have a little list here showing action required, and that shows all the list of documents that I need to sign. And from there, I can just hit sign and do the whole signing process for each of those. The other thing too, which is good to know with DocuSign, is if you need two people to sign a document, say you've got a work contract or employment contract and you want two people to sign it, you can actually sign it yourself, and then it'll actually go into the waiting for others until the other person has actually authorised the document and signed the document as well. So that's handy to have that there. You can also go down and see which ones I've also completed. So it's nice and easy handling directly from DocuSign. I'll just quickly go back to if you're waiting for others. If I've already signed a document and it needs someone else to sign it, once I've signed it, I'll actually get a message saying here that I'll receive the email copy once everyone has signed it. So I won't at that stage get a notification in my emails until it's been finalised. My document has been authorised and signed, and I've got my email saying that, yes, it's done. My job's done as an authoriser. I don't really know, you know, if I'm the big boss, I don't really care what's happening in the back end. I've signed it, not interested. But for those of us that then are going to be working in the back end, we do like to know what's going on. So once a document has been signed, it actually gets put back into Content Manager as a rendition. So, and I will suggest when you're doing this to wait a little bit. Sometimes it does take a little bit of time for the rendition to actually appear. But what happens is you can then view the rendition on your rendition tab down the bottom. There we go. So because I've got this column here, I can tell that's my one that's been finalised. It's already been approved. I can flick through it, and probably not that fast, so you can see what's happening. And there you go, I've got message in that there. So I know that that document's ready to go. So my next step then would be to actually finalise the document. And what happens is I can finalise, and you've got the option here to promote the signed copy rendition to make it the main copy of your record, which is what you'd want to do in this situation. It's our final, we don't want any more changes made, so I'm going to promote my signed rendition. I'm also going to keep the original document as a rendition, so I've got that behind the scenes if it's needed at all, and that just kind of flips them around. And in doing that, you'll notice it's actually been changed to a PDF now, so no more changes can be made to that once it's finalised in Content Manager. So it's handy to know.